Kazakhstan and the European Union established relations in 1993. The relationship strengthened in 1995 with the signing of a Partnership on Cooperation Agreement. Then in 2015, Kazakhstan and the European Union signed the Enhanced Partnership and Cooperation Agreement, which covers 29 areas of cooperation. This agreement has now been ratified by 23 countries out of 28 EU member states. It received consent from the European Parliament. So we expect that the ratification process will be completed soon, and the agreement may enter into force in full before the end of the year. It is already provisionally in force since 2016 because it was ratified by Kazakhstan as well as by the European Commission, which allows for the application of all those articles in the agreement which are under the purview of the European Union, including trade. And trade occupies about 70% of the agreement. 2017 was also important in that it was at that year that within the European Commission a decision was made to consider facilitating the visa regime with Kazakhstan. It is now for the European Commission to finalize their internal procedures and then to begin these negotiations with Kazakhstan over such an agreement. I would mention that the visa facilitation issue as well as the readmission issue are both mentioned in the Enhanced Partnership and Cooperation Agreement. So once this agreement is enforced, there is a legal obligation on both sides to engage in the talks over facilitating visa regime along with the readmission agreement and to sign such agreements, two agreements that need to be signed, that need to be signed at the same time. So we hope that the European Commission will get a mandate from the European member states to launch such negotiations with Kazakhstan before too long. In our turn, Kazakhstan has introduced a visa-free regime for all member states of the European Union and all member states of the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development in January 2017. Whereas these citizens of these countries can now visit Kazakhstan visa-free for up to 1 month. And the number of visits is unlimited, so if you stay in Kazakhstan for 30 days, then you can leave to do something else in your own country and then come back again. And we already are seeing a greater number of visitors from Europe. Of course, last year Kazakhstan hosted Expo 2017, where 120 countries participated, including, I believe, about 20, 21 or 22 European countries. We think that the facilitation of the visa regime for Kazakhstan citizens going to Europe will also promote this people-to-people contacts, cultural exchange, social exchange, educational exchange, and of course, business exchange. We think it will not cause much disruption, if at all, but it, in the end, it will help people get the visas easier and will certainly ease the travel. For your information, the United States, for example, has given Kazakhstan first a 5-year visa, and now there is a 10-year visa that Kazakhstan citizens can receive. For the European Union member states, there is no such procedure yet. In other words, Kazakhstan does not represent any potential challenge in terms of outward migration to the European Union member states. It's a self-sustaining state with a dynamically developing economy, living in peace with its neighbors, and as such posing no challenge, as I said. I don't want to even say a risk of outward migration, mass migration to the European Union. So facilitating a visa regime with Kazakhstan will benefit both sides. Generally, Kazakhstan, which straddles both Asia and Europe, can be called perhaps a part of Asia in Europe, because we are very much oriented towards Europe, frankly speaking, much more than we are oriented towards some of the countries in Asia. We see Europe as a source of technologies, as I said earlier, but also as a source of standards in both economic sense, but also in social sense.